two worlds, saved from destruction. Separate from one another, yet bound by magic. Tyrene, the human world. And Faerûn, a world of magic. These worlds may have been spared annihilation, but there is still work to be done. People to protect, places to visit, and adventure to be had. Welcome to Fractured Worlds, Guardians.
Dun, da, da, da. We're back, mother truckers!
Has it started?
Yeah, of course it started.
Oh, are we live right now?
Why would I do an epic intro like that if it hasn't started?
Oh, I don't know. Hi!
I don't know, you do weird shit from time to time, John.
I had no idea either.
I was like, normally it's like, okay, we're going live in 3, 2, 1.
No.
And nothing.
I read the intro. I was like, Guardians.
We're live, motherfucker. Oh, look at me.
I wouldn't get that excited if we weren't live. I would be.
I don't
like,
know about that. I've seen
John,
you.
You're always that excited.
Yeah, you're like.
You literally
like
have been at that level since we joined this call.
Jesus.
Whatever. Whatever. What's you, up, everyone? What?
He's
what?
On cocaine.
I'm cocaine. always constantly on cocaine, and I've never tried cocaine. Welcome to Dungeons and Dragons. This is actually, if it's your first time ever joining us, this is the best day to join us on. This is every 10 episodes we do a drunk D&D. It doesn't really follow the story, but it has to do with our characters we play, and it does follow the story though, so sort of, right? I mean, it affected the story last time. 10 episodes.
The beginning and the end is like the story.
Exactly.
You know?
The middle is just a shit show of drinking games, and you all can join along. So pop open your favorite bottle of scotch, grab yourself some Jameson, get yourself a beer. Get in the clear with some vodka, maybe
a Saison,
some tequila. Join
a Saison?
Me. A Saison. Ooh, Saza Gold. You can do a little. I'm doing a tequila sunrise today. What's everyone drinking, real quick, before we do start?
Wine.
What do we got?
Wine. Yeah, dude.
Jameson.
Fucking white wine.
Is that better?
Well, I'm Chaplin. I got to drink Jameson.
You look great. Oh, you zoomed in a little.
He was like, he's so small.
Dude,
I was like,
you looked good though. You
looked. Well, John's got that. Not Johnny's got that little controller. Like, I can just be like.
Yeah.
Anyway,
it's too close. It's too close. It's too close.
Go closer. Stop. This is my stream.
End the stream.
Stop.
End the stream.
I'm ending it.
This was a fun episode.
It's over. Thanks, guys, for watching.
Episode.
Peace. So, yeah, grab yourself
That's
a
actually
drink.
Terrifying.
Brad, you're not drinking tonight, right, Brad?
I can't drink. I'm on Red Bull because if I drink, then my meds will make me go do lally and nobody wants that on stream.
Do what?
Wait, do lally?
Do lally. I'm sorry, did I not enunciate it enough? That is very much a popular word among the elite.
What
of
is do lally?
Britain. Well, you go do lally, darling.
Does that mean like
do lally?
You die.
Is that like you like diarrhea?
It means
fancy?
I'll probably no. I mean, I might, but I mean, it could be anything. Like,
I mean,
it's just that
I
will go crazy.
I'm sort of down to take the chance.
Well, I don't know if you are, because I'll probably get naked and take a shit on my own webcam. Like, just like full.
Yes,
full
in the
view.
Chat. If you're down for it, I'll get banned for a day for that. I didn't do it. I'll get banned for a day.
Emma, bring me the whiskey.
Here you are, sir.
And a bucket.
And a bucket.
Bring me the whiskey and a bucket.
I brought you your whiskey.
See? Look at the chat. Look at them. They all want it. But no,
yeah.
I understand. When you take meds, you don't want to drink. Red Bull's for sure good for you with meds. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I'm about to say Red Bull is wonderful for when you're taking medication.
Well, I did. So
definitely
not
orange juice
a little quicker.
And tequila.
I drank some whiskey on it before, and it made me feel really weird. So I don't know, not like full crazy. I'm not talking like ketamine, K-hole, LSD trip, but just I felt a little bit weird, and so I was like, oh, maybe not again then.
Dude, it's all good. You gotta hold us together, so that's totally fine. Listen, we don't.
Brad's driving this car.
If also, yeah, exactly. If you can't drink, if you're underage or whatnot, you don't have alcohol, please don't feel
have
left out.
Milk.
Just have a drink in your hand. This is what I always
have
say
some
for
milk.
For
just
up
go
Friday.
Grab a Capri Sun.
Grab a Capri
no.
Sun.
No
water. Grab a Red Bull. Grab
Chug
milk.
Milk.
Honestly,
Chug
milk is probably more badass than all of the above.
So, Chug milk.
Milk.
Just,
Chug milk.
Just saying.
Chug it.
Chug it
chug
right
two,
now.
See if you can chug 3 pints of milk.
But this is
God,
definitely a fun, silly episode. Good times. We can't be as responsive as we normally are during our normal streams. Like, that's why you'll see us talking in chat, but we can't just be like, oh, Saint said smoke a joint. 420 blazing. Haha, dude, that was so funny. Hammerheading drummer, hype it up. Oh, yeah, dude. Thank you. Like, we can't be those people on this stream for today. So we love you. We're here for you in the chat. And Brad, we're going to let Brad just take it away. He's going to start us off with this intense music already.
Oh, yeah. I just clicked on it because I like this one.
Roll 20. Are you open?
Oh, I know. It's because he's got dual PC set up over here, so I have to open
it up. You have to open it up on the line.
I got to open it up on a different one, so.
Uh-huh. I just have it on two computers.
I want to say hi to everyone. I've missed all of you.
Yeah, honestly, it's been 2 weeks since we've done the show.
Yeah, I don't remember how to DM, but I can't believe people came back. I don't have to DM today.
We have like our normal amount of peeps hanging out in here, so like, thank you for coming back. Thank
it's
you for
because they love us.
They love us, I think so.
They love you.
I don't remember anything.
They come back for Elspeth, if we're all being completely honest.
Yeah, let's be real here. Elspeth
they
cares.
They all come back for Elspeth.
The only reason I'm here every week.
She cares.
I come back for Tiger, though.
Also, Brad, I want to link up.
I know you'd come for me.
Jesus. If you guys want to catch up on the episodes 1 through 9 of this season, I'm going to post it in chat as well. It's on Brad's channel now. It's on Brad's channel. There it is.
Everything's on my channel now. Now that I'm a partnered streamer.
Yes, Brad is now partnered on Twitch.
Now that I'm one of the elite.
Make sure to sub.
So if you guys sub to everyone on Fractured Worlds, we all have a hi emote. So you can do the Fractured Worlds Guardians hello.
Full hi.
I wish it spelled out Guardians.
We should each get a letter each or a couple of letters.
Too many letters. This is too
We could do like two each.
It's tough to think about.
And then
I mean, with all these random new emote slots, I don't know what to do with half of them. So might as well. Let's do this.
Put in $24.99.
I never thought I'd have that problem. I never thought that would be an actual problem.
Sorry. All
right. Even me with my 14 subs, I have too many as well. I got three, like, I was like, oh, I'll make three emotes and I'll be done. That'll be me forever. And then immediately it's like, oh, you have 400 slots. I was like, oh, okay.
Now people are complaining there's too many slots. It's like, never will be happy, ever.
All right, so.
Still can't hear the music.
Oh, yeah, D&D kind of, Discord. Do we have that link?
We do have a Discord, yeah.
I need to
There's
make
a lot of stuff.
These. I need to make. I
you
need
guys,
to
you guys can make. You can make a link. Everyone on the cast.
Oh, on the. Oh,
it,
I can do that. I can do that right now. Yeah, I'll
link. You guys can create.
If you ever want to talk on the Discord, hang out and chat while people are hanging out, you can do that. I will send you a link to the Discord right now, everyone. Okay, it's gonna be good.
Why can I not hear the music?
You need to go and get. Alaskan Savage to help you, I think.
No, he went to the store.
We can't
Holy
help
shit!
You.
How do I not fucking remember this episode where Tiger was the How do I not remember? Oh, I remember this part.
Wait,
I feel like Tiger. I was so drunk. I was so
this?
Drunk for that. It's
oh,
in the
Tiger's
Fractured
episode?
Worlds Discord.
I've never been more drunk. Wait, no, the episode's
I
gone.
Was so,
it was
I
deleted.
Must have been so trash not to
it?
Remember this.
Oh, it's a picture of Elspeth. Yeah.
What? Oh.
Oh, wait, no, that's today. People are already talking in there.
Hey, me.
See you guys on the other side.
Yeah, we'll see you on the other side. Hey,
is there music playing
right
now?
Yeah, right now it's banging.
My heart hurts. I love the music
for
our
show. Cheers in the chat. Oh. Shots in the channel. Our first drink, and then I actually second or third or fourth. Much love, much respect. Drink.
So, it's irrelevant mostly. Mm-hmm. What happened last week, but I'll give a quick roundup anyway. Essentially, the guys were in Thorellion, which is the place, the city of the Elven people. They went to deal with Mr. Erendil Venon, which is what are they called? Ancestor? No, I don't know. It's your great-great-grandfather. Miriam's great-great-great-grandfather, I think. They successfully managed to trick him into being killed by an enormous creature known as the Obsidian Dragon. But at the end, they found themselves at the mercy of an old friend. Way back when episode 10 of Fractured Worlds,
season one,
the guys dealt with this thing, this woman, this creature called Faelith, and she's a hag, a, like sort of like a night witch. and she appeared once again, sort of entranced the group, and then actually forced Clutch to fall in love with her, I think is what happened.
She charmed him, right?
Come on, she charmed,
him with...
Didn't I roll? Like, I lost,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, and you failed.
You lost.
I'm literally about to fuck another hag.
You are in love with her. Just because I want it to be a guarantee, we're going to go straight in the morning after.
No, you... Give me some roll chances, please, dude.
All right, if you can roll a 21, roll a d20.
Wow.
Give me one, like, literally give me one chance to not fuck this egg.
Roll a d20 plus one.
And if I get a 21, I did not fuck her?
You were unable to get hard.
Really, like, all right, I have...
Yep.
Oh, shit! Okay.
No, you fucked that. So...
Again.
So the evening wore on. The night.
Sweet, man. I didn't even get a shot.
100%.
No, mom, spaghetti for you.
Definitely going to.
I wouldn't have though. I'm waiting for my girl. I only have.
Yeah,
60
but this is magic.
that's true. I was charmed.
So you guys were.
There goes the memes.
You guys were all asleep apart from Clutch, who willingly went with the hag to her lair. It was a fairly long trek. You guys were asleep for the whole thing. You were thrown onto the back of a cart by Clutch and dragged away out of Thorellian and beyond and beyond and beyond. The hag opened a doorway.
Yes, she did.
and led you all back.
I'll drink to that one too. Yeah.
And led you all back to the cave. If you'll remember, once upon a time, you were in a cave.
You're in a lot of caves.
Yeah, we've done a lot of cave missions.
This was one of the first caves.
No,
this was the
cave.
This was the cave that you fought loads and loads of ghouls in.
Is this where that one guy died?
What's his name, Kevin?
No, this is the one where Pith got dragged into the by the evil dragon.
Oh, this is when we lost Oblivion.
Yeah, you were in this cave fighting ghouls, and then this is her home.
I remember.
You know that it's deep within the Dark Marsh somewhere because you looked out. Never actually went outside, and there was a huge swamp out there. You were able to work out, I think, that it was in the Dark Marsh. However, it is not as simple as it seems, for this is a hag who is an extremely powerful illusionist. The type of power that allows me to do what I want. Welcome to the dream world.
Yeah! That's already fun. Welcome to the dreamer.
So you guys find yourselves in what is kind of really similar to the hollow common room of the Satyr home in the Great Hollow Tree.
Yeah,
there's a huge stage in the center of the room, and there is loads and loads of people around. They're all dummies. There are lots and lots of dummies all sat at tables around you with little faces that have been stitched on or drawn on crudely, smiling and wildly happy. Three of you are mostly confused, but you awaken here. One of you is slightly less confused, but a little confused, Clutch. However, you're less petrified and worried about the situation because behind the bar is Faelith, the wonderful hag. Not just any old hag. not just any old hag. She is
just not that Sally Hag, yeah.
She is your love. She is your love and
so
your
I'm still
lover.
Charmed.
Yeah. Okay. You are charmed and in love with this beautiful woman.
Yeah,
so
she's
for the record, Faelith, this hag, she's very thin. Her skin is like tight to her bones and her hands. She's got very like thick but kind of patchy, greasy, dark hair that just falls in clumps and dreads. Her hair is like falling out half the time. She'll like scratch it and bits of her scalp will peel off. She's got like rotten clothes on. Like she's probably had this same outfit.
I'll have what he's having.
100 years. She's got like a mottled mouth with a sort of her skin and her lips kind of peeled back a little too far over her broken black teeth. She does have an elven face, but it's very blotchy and purpley, kind of tightly over her skull that she almost looks like a ghoul herself. And she has these kind of elven ears that poke out. She's grotesque, but she is smiling at you and she's making drinks behind the bar. Other than Faelith, there is one other person in the room with you, and it's a satyr. And almost as soon as you guys wake up and come to and find yourselves here in the in this kind of common room, the satyr begins to speak. Lights come down from the ceiling in all sorts of different arrays of colors and start to flash around, and the satyr begins to speak. So the satyr stands up and he has a little tiny orb that he holds in his hand, and when he speaks into the orb, his voice booms out and echoes off the walls really, really loudly. The satyr says, "Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Hags Game Show!" And the lights flash like crazy. "I'm your host, Baxham Van Baxham Real. Let's introduce our guests. Take it away, voiceover guy." And then a voice speaks from above you. Whenever the voice is speaking about you, you are compelled for some reason to look at the camera and just smile and wave. We've got Poo Poo Cakes. He's a 400-year-old satyr from the Great Hollow Tree. He's looking to win his freedom and get back to his long-lost pet, the Voidling.
Our
next contestant is... You can now stop smiling. Chaplin. He's a 27-year-old angelic descendant from the other side. With a chest as hard as his hard-on for Miriam, he's hoping to win his freedom and get back to sailing his little boat.
Yes!
And then the lights shine.
Drink that one. Drink
the lights
one.
Shine on Miriam. Yeah. We've got Miriam. She's a 42-year-old halfling from Barrow's Bottom, hoping to win her freedom so that she can get back to her finger pies. But I'll bet that's not all she wants fingered, is it, Miriam? We hear a certain Iron Hand is out there waiting for you with love on the horizon. The lights brightly shine again, and then they set along Clutch. We've got Clutch, the 24-year-old model from the other side. His beautiful face, his luscious hair, and triceps that'll make your hardest witch go weak at the knees. Clutch is hoping to win his freedom to return to that whore Tizari the Oracle. But we're sure he'll come to his senses and stay behind with his true love, Faelith the Night Hag. And all of the lights shine on Faelith the Hag, and for a moment she looks beautiful and resplendent. You all saw her previously. She looks wonderful in her like an elven form, and then immediately it all dissipates and she's her horrible grotesque self again. Hey!
Dude, that worked out pretty well. Incredible that this is how it's going down. So we're playing game show.
This is how it's going to go. It's a game show. Okay, so you each have a little health bar above your characters there.
Yep.
If you double click your character, you'll see under basic that you have a bar.
Oh, God.
I think it should say 5, but if it doesn't, change it.
Yeah, I can see this bar.
So that is your sanity points.
So I have 10 out of 10, right?
Change it to 5 out of 5.
Okay.
So you basically can lose or win them as you play against the hag during the games. Every time you roll a 1, not only do we have to drink, because that's part of the D&D drinking game rules, but you also have to kiss the hag.
Yes!
Every time you kiss the hag, you lose a sanity point. And every time you drop below 5, you gain an indefinite madness flaw that you take on with you into the future of Guardians.
No. So every time you kiss the hag, you bring something with you in the future?
Every time you kiss the hag, you lose a sanity point. And once you get to 0, it goes back up to 5, but you take a madness flaw.
Oh, no.
I have a trump card.
I have a trump card.
He has a trump card.
It's true.
Okay. I believe you.
I believe you.
Brad told me about the other day. He'll remember eventually.
You already have one. Is that what your trump card is?
I don't know. Is that my trump card? I feel like it should be.
I don't know. No, you can have multiple of these things.
You can be crazy.
If you go to zero like 20 times tonight, you'll have 20 madness floors that you'll have to deal with. but you probably won't. So that's like the basics of what's going on. I'll give you more information as we play. Baxon Christ, what the fuck is his name? Baxon Fam Baxon Reel spins around on the stage and says, "Let's warm up with a simple game of The Hag is Right." And then all these numbers start spinning on this huge board next to him. Now this is a simple game. I'm gonna roll a number. You have to guess whether it will be higher or lower. If you guess right, you don't have to drink and you don't have to kiss the hag. If you guess wrong, you have to drink and you have to kiss the hag.
All right, let's go. Hey, and
simple
and,
as that.
And people playing at home, they should just pick their contestant to drink with, correct?
Sure. Yeah. Pick a person.
Boom.
Go.
Boom.
Pick your
don't pick me
racehorse.
Unless you want to get drunk.
Pick your racehorse.
Oh man.
Your racehorse?
In this game.
All right.
Go to the glue factory, boys. This is going to suck ass.
So, this is just a real simple game of higher or lower with D20. So, I'm going to roll a D20.
All right.
And then you tell me individually what you think. So, you're each individually going to work out which number will come next.
Cool.
Yeah. 14. Yes. Go.
Wait, what? What is
so
it?
So do we all say what we think?
What, who
yeah,
goes?
You're all individual players.
Okay,
lower. What is Poopoo doing?
I'm confused.
We say
I'm
lower.
What are you confused?
Who is? We're all yelling. We all have to make the unanimous decision.
Yeah, 14. No, individually.
No.
You can be
individually.
You can be ballsy.
Wait. So we have to fit. What the fuck? So we have to pick if this is if the number that you're thinking is higher or lower?
No.
The 14?
The number I'm thinking.
Next
no.
Number he
the
rolls.
Next number that I roll
is
will
be
it be higher or lower than 14?
Oh, this is based on chance.
This is a card game. I'm gonna say lower.
Lower.
Poo-poo.
Lower.
Right. Lower. Lower for sure.
Lower for sure?
For sure.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah! Lower.
Oh,
hey. All right. So that means you each get nothing. It's fine. Nothing.
Sweet.
Don't worry. I have some vague rules here. All right. Higher or lower than 6?
Higher.
Yeah, I'm going to say higher as well.
Everyone's saying higher?
Yeah.
Higher. Yes.
Yeah.
Or lower than 10.
Higher.
Lower. I like the low balling.
Higher.
They're all doing higher and I'm doing lower?
Lower, yep. McLoken.
Higher.
Get fucked, guys. You should listen to Clutch always.
I'm doing higher.
What if it's the same?
What happens if it's the same?
Makes it, takes it. We win. John loses.
No, you need
this is the Hag's world. You lose. All of you.
We all lose.
Yeah, drink.
That's some bullshit.
Cheers.
You need to guess the same. From the back, the hag says, "You have to guess the same." And then all of you see the beautiful hag walk out from around the bar and head towards the table. As she leans down first towards her lover Clutch, she puckers up, and you feel compelled to give her a kiss.
Absolutely, no problem.
Okay, you lose a sanity point.
Oh.
You're on 4 of 5.
All right.
She moves over to Chaplin. She leans in. Now, Chaplin, this is way more grotesque for you because you're not enthralled by her. She smells like urine. And then you smell her breath, which is like a mixture of like really, really old gasoline.
Oh my god!
Oh, dude!
So
all of her teeth are rotten. All of them are rotten. It's like trash. She puckers up to give you a kiss, and you feel compelled to give her a kiss.
Why do I feel compelled? Can I resist?
Nope.
God damn it. Mwah.
Mwah. Lips. Lips and tongue.
God!
I'm just gonna drink and cry.
she moves around and leans down to the much smaller form and frame of Pith. Puck her up. She leans in for a kiss. Her lips are so thin and pulled back over her teeth. You have to kiss a bit of teeth when you come in.
Oh my God, this is so hot.
Yeah.
Damn.
And then she moves around to... She moves around a poo-poo cake. She strokes him under his chin like a goat likes.
Oh, they're getting into it.
The kiss rolls in.
Oh, that was awful.
All right, let me roll him.
No offense to you, hag.
No, she's fucking loving it. She struts away, wiggling her butt. Baxum real up there. Oh, yes, this was wonderful. That was a nice set of kisses there. And for a moment, Baxum Fan Baxum real kind of like jitters.
I think her tooth is in my
weirdly.
Mouth.
You sick in your mouth. Let's see, 4. Poo poo cakes. You are now rolling higher or lower for everyone else.
What?
Okay.
Why?
That means I don't have to drink, so I'm fine, right?
Yeah, including the hag.
Okay, so 1.
Hag shouts higher.
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 Come on, 1.
Yeah! 6. Higher.
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 Oh.
Higher.
Mary.
Higher.
Lower. No.
Yeah.
Higher.
I mean, shocks.
First of all, she leans in for a kiss. Mwah. Tongues and everything. You lose another sanity point.
Oh, shit. I'm at 3.
Make sure you mark them off on your character sheet on that bar. So you double click your thing and then you knock it down to 3 or whatever.
Yeah.
And everyone else needs to knock it down as well by 1. You're on 4 of 5.
Oh, no, yeah, I'm already done. Yeah. So wait, what? Should we do higher or lower?
1, 2, 3, 4. This is the last one. 5.
Higher!
Higher.
Lower.
Oh, the hag said lower.
Yeah.
Roll it, Ty.
No!
Yeah!
There's a moment where the entire bar shifts and change, and you just get a quick glimpse of... the cave outside. Baxum Fan Baxum Real shifts and change, and he's just a zombie just standing there for a moment in the middle of the cave. All of the dummies disappear, the tables and everything, and then it reforms, and the hag is like shaking her head. She hits it on the top. She pours herself a wonderful looking cocktail, mixes it up, heads over to your table, pours you each a drink, hands them out, and then heads back behind the bar. Baxum Fan Baxum Real shouts, "Right there, whose turn is next?" And it's Clutch, your turn to do the roll-in.
Yes, yes, yes. All
5 right. D20s.
Does anyone think that he's way too happy to kiss the hag?
Shh. 3. What y'all think?
Lower.
Higher.
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 Wait,
yes.
why is she saying lower? Is it the same rules? Is it the same rule?
Yep, you got it, you got it, you got it. Number
definitely
2, higher or
like
lower than 11?
Higher.
Higher.
Higher. For sure, higher.
Who said lower? Drink,
the
mother trucker.
The hag.
Oh, that's a kiss. Hag, over there. Over there. Kiss
who did it?
I did.
You?
Chaplain.
Oh, yeah, she comes in for a bit of that asthma. She loves the taste of that asthma. You know,
dead ass of her.
Dead ass of her, though.
Dead ass of her.
She leans in. She grips you with her horrible claw-like hands and brings your head up to her, and she gives you a long smooch.
Ooh.
The smell is overwhelming. And then she leans back and.
Is he out of it now?
What's his points?
Oh, no, does he keep going higher and lower?
Yeah.
All right, higher and lower, 15.
Lower.
Lower.
Hag?
Higher.
Oh, it's lower. You lose again. All right, she, last one.
She stands for a moment, shaking her head. Not too happy.
Higher or lower, 13. Final round.
Lower. Higher.
Lower.
I'm going to go higher.
Lower.
Lower.
Lower!
I high-five the hag.
Yeah, she high-fives you and struts over. Who loses points and has to drink?
Oh,
what
God.
Is on your hand? Don't touch your hands. Don't touch your hands.
It's like touching, layers of grease. It's
Brad.
It's like touching. She's got like a thin layer of like petroleum jelly levels of grease on her entire body.
I swipe my hand off on the corner of Piss' arm. Just
who's getting a kiss?
Oh, I'm already getting kissed.
I'm sorry. I just did not want this on my hand.
Who takes a kiss and a sanity point? Just you?
Not me. I do too.
All right, she grips each of you at the same time.
That is still so hot. That is so hot.
you see Chaplin just grab the whiskey afterwards, and he's like rinsing his mouth out with it.
All right, who's next? Hang on, let's see here. Chaplin, your turn. Baxum points at Chaplin. All of the lights shine and point on Chaplin. Your turn there, sir!
Don't
roll
mind if I do.
Dice.
Okay. Let's do this.
Five times.
Is the first one like a base, or are we doing higher or lower off the last roll?
No, the first one is the base.
Okay.
10.
Lower.
Oh,
lower. I'm going lower, 100% lower.
I'll go higher, too. Higher.
Two highs, one lower.
We need to go lower. One lower.
Come on,
please.
High.
Caleb, what are you doing?
Higher.
Oh!
I am the winner. Give me all of your money.
Oh, no.
Baxum falls off the stage. Boom. He looks dead for a moment, and then he shakes himself off and stands up. Oh, don't mind me. And then he steps up on the stage and carries on.
Oh, no, he's shorting out.
are people getting some kisses?
Yes, that's me.
Kisses?
Hello.
You get a kiss?
Yes.
She heads, and you? She heads over and deep tongues clutched. and then heads over and deep tongues pit
kinda
as
like,
well.
Does she get as deep to the point where it's
tongue,
AM flux?
Her tongue is like points. A fucking... Her tongue is like a snake.
Oh, AM,
as well.
Oh God!
It tickles the back of your throat a little bit. She gets all the way in.
Oh God!
Does she AM flux like a tooth and put
a circle of life.
It's like a porn kiss.
I don't know why I'm sticking that song.
I don't know all why right. You guys keep kissing her. You just gotta use your brain and choose the right numbers, guys. Come
okay.
on.
Okay. Higher or lower?
Higher.
Higher.
Lower.
Okay.
What, if you get it right again, Poop, I'm roll.
Son of a bitch.
You two make
Poo-poo.
Out. You two
she heads over to. She heads over to Poo Poo Cakes. She looks like she's getting a headache a little bit, but she shakes it off, and then she grips him by the cheeks, grabs whatever hair she can get hold of on his goatee face. She gives him a big old, a wide, open mouth smooch, and then a tooth falls out in his mouth.
Oh, God. I grab the tooth with my tongue.
Oh!
Pure dirt.
Wait, what's wrong with your clutch?
What do you mean?
Why would you do that?
What do you mean? She's beautiful.
Are you out of your mind?
Wait, she tickled your biscuits one time, but Jesus.
Oh, Poopoo does not look like he's in a good way.
Oh,
I don't think any of us look like we're in a good way. We've been kissing.
Was that a tooth? Was that one of her teeth?
Two more rolls, more that kisses, was one of boys and girls.
I want to roll. Can I roll a check real quick to see if that was a real tooth or if it was an illusion tooth?
You can roll me an Arcana check.
Please don't be real. Please don't.
Doesn't matter, I swallowed it.
I don't want you to be swallowing anything right now. I just want this to be real. This had her mouth in my mouth.
pretty convinced it's a real tooth.
Oh no, no.
She seems to be the only other real thing. You guys seem real and she seems real. Everything else seems like an illusion to you. And you're pretty good with illusions, so. It was probably a real tooth.
I look defeated as much as a man can be defeated. Or a girl can be defeated.
Baxen fam, Baxen real shouts. It's time for the next round.
Oh, no next round. We're friends. We're brothers.
Is that it? Is that we're done? Are we win?
You feel your hand beginning to shake the dice up in it.
Okay, higher or lower?
Then 16, lower.
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 Faileth?
Lower.
Yeah. Lower. Did you say higher?
No one said higher.
Okay. And then the last roll.
Higher.
Higher.
Oh!
Just about. The lights spin and shake around the room. Baxen fam, Baxen real points over at Miriam. And the last round goes to the little one from Barrow's Bottom.
It's me.
And the lights shine on you. Roll me a
d20. All right. Here we go, boys.
All right. Definitely
seven.
Higher.
Higher.
Everyone says higher.
Higher.
All right.
Yeah.
Lower.
Lower? Does everyone say lower or higher?
Lower.
Yeah.
Oh, my face!
Everyone drinks. The entire fucking thing shuts down for a moment as you guys find yourselves once again back here in the cave for a moment. You each like wake up. You find that you're like here for a moment, but is anyone at zero yet?
No.
Okay.
I'm at two.
You kind of like look around and you see just ahead of you, you see the hag shaking her head. She looks up and sees all of you, and as you all open your eyes and look at her, she goes and then suddenly once again you are back in the game show. And you see her again shaking her head.
Worst nightmare.
And then she shouts, lower.
Please just be low. If you roll those, thank goodness.
That is a one from Miriam though, so you still have to drink, Elspeth.
Fuck a duck.
I mean, she has kissed too.
No.
What? I just drink.
Oh, we
higher
drink.
Lower.
You don't have to if you didn't fuck it up. Oh, yeah, everyone, yeah, everyone said up. Lower.
Yeah.
Higher.
Higher.
Yeah.
Done. The house lights all come up and the whole room illuminates once again. Mr. Fax. What the fuck is his name? Baxen fam. I haven't even got an excuse for not drinking. Baxen fam. Baxen real. He's almost. What's that fucking dude from Superman, McLoken? Fucking Mr. Mixel.
Mr. Mixel Pixelixies. Mixelflix.
Yeah. He's a fucking stupid name like that.
It's Mr. Fambaxum.
He says, "That's it for the warm-up rounds and games. Now on to the real game show."
That sounded scary. What do you mean? That was the warm-up.
That was the warm-up. He hits the board, and then suddenly you see. You see all these things appear on the board. There it is. I think yes. On the board, all these like lines tick appear, and then Faileth clicks her fingers, and then the table next to you, which is this table here, moves over to where you guys are. The dummies fall to the ground, their little dumb eyes looking up at you. And then you see, give me a second. I haven't DM'd for a couple of weeks. I can't remember what I'm doing. It's
I'm already buzzing, ooh. Man. I'm already buzzing.
We'll yeah. get there.
Probably I don't drink as much anymore, so like I'm already like this far through the bottle, and I'm like, I'm feeling pretty good.
Man. Boom.
What?
Here.
Oh my God! Yes.
Oh, what?
So, the table next to you turns into a wheel of fortune, and Baxen Fan Baxen Rule says, after the break, we'll be playing some Wheel of Fortune. Brrr. And then we go to a break.
Holy crap. This is awesome.
I totally wish we had so commercials fun. For this. Like,
dude, if we had commercials like D&D commercials, like, hey, it's me, Clutch. If you ever need to get hard, I got the thing for you.
It's so what's happening in each of your brains. One of the others is making a commercial.
Yeah.
For something oh my God, like arrows so and spells or something.
I would like to think it's like religious saloon commercials. It's like, find the church of saloon today.
Yeah, you're just like, yeah, for sure. I was assuming mine would be something along the lines of, want to be free of religion, free of people like Chaplin and stupid people like Clutch. Well, you can join me and Piss in a world
yo,
where
it's dude, that's awesome. Hey, we will be right back. I gotta refill my drink, to be honest. This is empty.
Yeah.
So I refill
don't have
your
to
drinks.
Refill mine.
I have to already pee.
We'll be back in like 2 minutes. Not even. Peace. One. Welcome back. We are back, everyone. Welcome back to the game show.
Well, we've just learned we can punch each other. Yeah,
we can punch each other. We can punch each other. Yeah. So
welcome
excited.
Back, everyone. Let's go.
All right. So all of the lights begin shining, and then the table next to you turns into a wheel of fortune. We need you to roll initiative.
Oh, no. Fuck yeah,
Do I still get advantage?
Do I still get advantage because of my boots?
Roll me a d20.
Oh yeah, das boots. Oh.
Das boots and wait, I roll a d20?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I have the shittiest initiative.
You look down and you're barefoot.
No!
There we go, good.
Fuck, guys.
One put her in her place.
You
all right, where the fuck?
Wait. Is Marion the type of hobbit to wear shoes?
She wears boots, you imbecile.
Well, I mean, is she a river folk or is she a fucking hill folk?
She has magic boots.
What are we rolling? Initiative?
Initiative.
All right, I can do that. Maybe an hour. Like 20 hours. There we go.
I'm going to take a drink. Welcome back, everyone.
Drink. This is the order in which you will be spinning the wheel.
Okay.
So, Baxen Fam Baxen Brill says...
Didn't you make the name?
Yeah.
He makes the name every time.
Is he eating kale right now?
Baxen Fam Baxen Brill.
It's an apple pencil.
What the fuck is an apple pencil?
It's like one of these candies. I don't know.
Is that a European thing?
That's got to be a European thing.
Yeah, I've never
heard of that. Name our candy after writing utensils. We're not that dumb.
It looks like this.
Cool green straws you can eat.
Yeah, right? Silly straws.
Silly straws.
No, yeah. Not silly straw. That'd be like the sour punch.
Bread.
The sweet tart sour punch fruit punch straws.
Right? Mm-hmm. Something involving punch because it's American.
America!
And we punch.
And we punch here.
Thanks for shopping at Bad America.
Betsy's shopper handicapples.
Okay, Brad, take it away.
Baxen Fam Baxen Brill says.
Someone laughed in the audience in my. Like, dude, as you said that, I heard like a voiceover of a chick go.
I heard that too.
That was awesome.
The Sasha says.
Oh my god.
You will each have a chance to spin the Wheel of Fortune, or you could say Misfortune, ha ha ha! Then he explains that basically, you will have a chance to, this is like Hangman, right? There's a word, top left, so you're gonna have to jump between the two. Top left of the map, there is a set of words that you need to guess.
What?
You're
making this hard for me, huh?
Oh, I got this. Just zoom out a lot if you need to.
Yo, this is like Hangman!
Oh my god.
This is like Wheel of Fortune!
Yeah, it's similar. It's close enough.
Wheel of Hangman.
It is Wheel of Fortune. Whoops.
You spin the wheel. Whatever it lands on happens regardless. And then you get a question. If you answer the question correctly, you can guess a letter. If you want to try and guess the thing, guess the actual word or whatever it is, phrase, you can do so. But if you fuck it up, you lose a sanity point.
Oh my gosh.
Shit.
This is like in depth.
If you get it correct,
uh-huh.
The person who gets it correct breaks free of the illusion.
Oh, you mean the phrase? The game?
Whoever gets it correct will break free of the hag's illusion.
Oh shit!
And gets
out.
Let's go. I mean,
so the first person to spin the wheel is Clutch. If you'd like to spin the wheel, roll a d24.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for the offer. 1d24. slash roll 1d24. Big money, big money. No whammies, no whammies, no whammies. Shoot. 11.
11, which is, you lose a sanity point.
I'm at one, man.
Immediately, you lose a sanity point. But you do get the first question.
Ooh, okay.
So,
do I have to look at the camera for this one?
So, because of chat, me and John had to work this out. I was like, there are trivia questions, and they're just going to say in chat. He was like, right, these are the rules. When you're being asked a question, you have 30 seconds to answer, and you have to look at your webcam. You can't look anywhere else. If you look anywhere else, you instantly foul the question.
Chat might give away the answers.
Because chat can give you the answer.
So chat, you can talk about the answers. We're going to be staring at the camera so we don't cheat.
I'm getting my 30 seconds.
Bring it on.
Oh my God. Right. Trivia, boys, let's go.
Trivia. It's all D&D. All D&D trivia.
Oh, I'm going to lose so hard.
It's going to be really difficult, but most of them are true or false. A couple of them aren't, including this one.
No,
so,
no.
Faxum, Baxum, Bomb, Baxum, Berry says, a barbarian with the bear totem is resistant to all damage except for one. Which type? 30 seconds.
Wait, ask the question one more time.
A barbarian with the bear totem is resistant to all damage except for one. Which type of damage?
Slashing. Come on!
Unfortunately, the answer was psychic damage.
Oh, what D&D are we playing? This is 5e, motherfucker.
Jesus Christ,
5e
man.
Questions only. All the lights flash red, and you don't get to guess a letter.
I don't know shit about barbarians now. Fuck, man.
D&D! We're so fucked.
You're so fucked.
We're so done.
If it's like third edition D&D, I'd be like, oh, this is my shit. This is fifth edition where I don't know all that much.
The lights shine on Chaplin. Now, some of these, like this one, is probably going to be really nice that this one landed on Chaplin. Maybe. We'll see, McCloaken. How it goes. The lights all shine on you. Spin the wheel. 1d24.
Oops, I spelt that wrong. 1d24.
I spelt 1d24 wrong.
One.
Oh, one. Drink. So you have to drink in real life.
Yes.
You also have to drink the drink that the hag put in front of you, which looks like a really nice cocktail and tastes like a really nice cocktail, but in real life is like pissy mud and worms, like mushed up. So in like the real world, Chaplin's
good source
kind
of
like just eating mud from the ground. But in the game, he's he's drinking from a lovely cocktail glass. Okay. Remember, you have to look at the camera as the Faxum Boxum Bang Boxum Berry says to you.
If your eyes are bright camera, you drink.
The question is, a red dragon is a metallic or a chromatic dragon?
Chromatic.
Bring! All the lights flash green.
Oh!
Yeah. He gets. You get to guess a letter on the what is essentially Hangman up there.
I picked the letter R.
R. The Faxum Baxum Bomb Baxum Berry looks over and says, "Is there an R?" And there is. And it goes, excuse me here, because this is bullshit and roll 20. There!
No, Brad.
It's the only way I can do it. I swear to God, it's the only fucking way I can do it.
No, we MSK, boys.
No, there's
got
to be. Can add text, dude.
Yeah, but it's bullshit. Yeah. I'm not. Oh, fuck, I've lost the top one now. See, this is why I didn't want to do it. This is why I didn't want to fucking do it. Where is it? Where the fuck did it go?
Oh my God.
There it is.
There it is. Oh, fuck. Wait. To the front. There we go.
Ta-da! No. Okay.
The illusion starts falling apart. It's like shuddering in and out. That's the only R. That's the only R. We're in MS Paint. Hey, you're in a fucking hag's illusion. It looks like it looks like how I want it to look. She says,
it looks how I want it to look.
Wow. Okay. We got it, miss. We got it.
All of the lights shine on Poo Poo Cakes. And you get to spin the Wheel of Fortune. Roll me a D24.
Oh!
24.
Whoa, baby!
100 gold.
Actually, Chaplin has to drink. Poopoo, you can tell someone to drink because you've got a crit. That was the original drinking rules, remember?
What?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Elspeth.
Yeah.
God damn it.
Poopoo, you gain 100 gold in your actual inventory.
Fuck yeah,
dude,
boy.
That's a lot of money.
That's a lot of kusho. You know what I'm saying? That's like, I got 100.
Someone's benefiting from this, and it ain't me.
You get an actual 100 gold added to your inventory, and you
damn,
take that on.
Son.
real illusionary gold.
Okay.
It's not illusionary, it's real.
Money in our campaign. That's crazy.
And Baxen from Fan Baxen Brill says, okay, now time for your question, Mr. Poo-Poo Cakes. My fellow Satyr! And as soon as he says the word Satyr, he changes into a horrible, ghoulish, undead human and then changes back.
This is scary.
Remember, you have to look at the screen. It's always really difficult doing this because I have to make it fun, but also it's almost always the, like last time you were in hell. Okay.
Never been there before.
The question is, an attack roll against a prone creature has advantage when at range. True or false? 30 seconds.
True.
All of this light turn red.
That's so false. Dumb.
You have advantage when you're at melee range, not at range.
You have disadvantage because they're prone and they're
You actually have disadvantage at range because they're like
make
lying
out
down.
With the hag.
And it's harder to do. You you take a sanity point off. The hag just licks your face from chin all the way around to the center of your forehead.
Do I still have hair on my beard where that was at, where she licked?
Yeah, it's just greasy now and gross.
I wipe my face off on the side of Chaplin.
Stop wiping yourself on people!
I'm sorry! You guys have clothes! I don't look at these clothes with hair! I'm bare-chested in here.
The lights shine once again, and they settle on Pith. You get to spin the wheel by rolling
wheel
a d24.
Wheel time! Okay, now this is slash R 1d24.
Space 1d24, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
bam! 24. It spins round 360. You take 100 gold.
Pick someone to drink.
How are you doing that?
And you get to pick someone to drink.
Can I make the hat drink?
No.
Oh yeah, I guess I can't really.
Can't make the hag do anything.
This one's going to Mr. Clutch.
Ah, yay.
Ah, cheers. Appreciate that. Thank
you. I had an assumption. I didn't want to go with it.
And you get a question. Mr. Faxon Bombaxon player says to you as the lights, you have to look at the camera. 10 gold pieces is worth 100 silver pieces. True or false? 30 seconds.
10 gold pieces
is worth 100 silver pieces.
This is math.
Oh, it's math.
Is math.
It's like awkward math.
False!
Oh my god.
False. Oh no.
Well,
all of the lights shine.
True.
10 times 10 is 100.
I'm muting you, McLoken. I'm muting you, McLoken.
The lights all turn red, and you don't get to guess another letter. Your hope is looking slim of ever breaking free of this illusion. And
is no one at zero yet?
Is anyone at zero? No.
Wow.
Uh-oh.
No, but you need to guess this thing to break free.
You guys only have like one left though. Like
you can only guess on your turn. Okay. At the end of your turn, by the way, at the end of each of your turns, when you spin the wheel and you've answered the question, whether you get it right or wrong, you can attempt to guess the thing you want. But remember, you lose a sanity to try and guess it.
I thought 100 silver was the goal.
100 silver
is 1 gold.
10 silver is 1 gold.
Don't worry.
See, that's why you don't ask Elspeth calculation questions.
Like, we talked about this on.
But, like, imagine the thing is, it could have gone to anyone else. It was all on the initiative roll, which is why I did that.
Ooh, interesting.
You know what I mean?
It's unfortunate McLoden didn't get that question.
Yeah, you'll probably feel that way about a few of these. Because, in general, if Chaplin was allowed to answer all of them, if you were an actual pub team instead of an individual team, you'd have a much better chance.
Your pub quiz.
Yet the hag doesn't allow it, laughing and slapping her knees behind the
John's question was fucking hard. That was like way oddly specific.
Yeah, it was pretty tough. But that's what happens when you're in a hag.
Then I feel my question like after it's like, is a red dragon a chromatic dragon or a metallic dragon?
I don't think any of the
like...
others would have necessarily known that though. I don't know. Some of them are hard, some of them ain't. Clutch!
Yeah.
The light will shine on you. You get to spin the wheel
no
of fortune.
I would love to.
Wheel of fortune.
There, here it goes. Big money, 24.
one, drink, and then drink again.
I'm adding this gold to my inventory.
How do I ask for a 24? I ask for it nicely, and then it just gives me the crappiest thing ever.
Because it's RNG.
RNG.
Two drinks, and then the old, what is it called? Those their lights come down. For your question.
Okay.
Paxson from Blackson Free says... I'm giving up. I'm on a different page to the page where his name is now, and I can't ever remember.
Just call him Pax.
I'll never know.
Paxson Don Daxon Free.
Daxon von Glaxengree says
Glaxengree.
The maximum range of a dart is 60 foot. True or false? 30 seconds.
True.
Ba-da-bing.
Correct. Really? It is true. Yeah. Maximum range of a dart is 60 feet.
What's up,
the
y'all?
The lights all turn green, and you get to guess a letter if you would like to.
A.
A. All right, here we go.
Yeah, we need some more vowels up in here.
Baxon Mon Baxonbury points. Is there an A?
There better be an A.
There is two A's.
Yeah.
And it goes, one is there, and the other. Is there? Oh. Oh god, imagine if I was drinking, this would be even worse. It's my absolute try hard best. The lights all shine once again. Is that the last one? Yeah, all right, there we go. Sorry, I'm a bit blind. The lights shine again, once again, on Chappers. Old
Wait,
Chaplin.
Can I solve?
If you want to.
I can't.
What?
I can't.
Okay.
I was like, no way.
You can attempt to whenever you
All
want.
All right. All
right. Can Chaplin. We attempt to solve it if it's not our turn and we know it?
And
you can only do it on the end of your turn.
Okay.
Yeah. Wheel of Fortune rules. Okay. I spin the wheel.
Wow.
Spin it.
I'm getting into it.
I spin the wheel. I spin on this wheel.
Chaplin, 15.
Kiss the hand.
Oh, he's gone. He's a zero.
This sucks for him.
I'm at zero.
The hag runs over to you and she grips you, and you see the madness in her eyes, and you feel it for a moment grip you as the fear chills your entire spine. Oh. And she gives you a big old smooch. Oh, you can't take it anymore. The horror, the disgusting hag face, the black voodoo. You take an indefinite madness. Roll me a D100 and set your sanity back to 5.
1d100.
No, but snake.
Yeah, I know. Oh, I know.
Oh, man. This could be bad.
Let it be good.
So the D100. This is all right. This is okay. This one's not too bad for Chaplin. You now add this to your flaws on your character sheet.
Oh, dear.
Being drunk keeps me sane.
Actually, no, that actually works out very well for Chaplin.
That's not too bad for Chaplin, because one of Chaplin's flaws is already that he's kind of a drunkard.
Yeah.
But now it's like, you have to do it or you be an asshole.
Son of a bitch.
Chaplin drinks more than he normally does now?
No. Chaplin always drinks. Like,
it's kind of his thing anyway. It's not a huge deal. Set your thing back to 5. You can still lose some points. Bad. Okay, and then the lights dim down on you. For your question, Chaplin, Paxson Daxon Glong Glacklinson there says to you, wait, I need my timer. All right, there it is. A whip deals 1d4 bludgeoning damage when held in one hand. True or false?
False.
30 seconds. Boom. False. Immediate answer. All of the lights. Ring. All green.
What the
it
heck?
It is false. It deals slashing. It deals slashing damage.
You're so good.
Dude, I can DM a campaign. I have to know this shit.
You may guess a letter. One of you has to have a good chance.
I'm going to do S.
Huh? S.
With the letter S. Like in snake.
I like that. S as in snake. Snake.
I don't know why nobody's picked an E yet. Why is
it? Excuse me.
I can fill in all these.
Is there an S? He falls down on his head. You see his head explode. His head breaks on the edge and he stands up. Oh, sorry, I felt myself go a little dizzy. Yet no other letters appear. Faxon von Baxenbury's bleeding nose he points up at the lights and they shine once again and land on Poo-Poo Cakes. Poo-Poo. Unless you want to guess, but you're guessing you probably don't want to guess.
No, I don't. I'm terrible at these, so I have no idea yet.
All right. Poopy Cake, spin the wheel of fortune.
Hadouken! What? Hold on. Why is it doing this? Wow. What? I'm an idiot.
You can just press up. It goes through the last few things you rolled if you just press up.
It's not me all being stupid right now.
I can roll for you.
I got it. I see what was going on. I think I know what I figured out. Two.
It's like the imagery of this guy falling on his face. And then getting back up and being like, it's fine.
Whoa, Brad, are you moving the wheel to two?
Yeah. Yeah.
Woo. Congrats, dude.
Dude, I'm a professional, okay? way too much effort.
I lose a sanity point.
Two, you lose a sanity point. What does that put you to?
One.
You're on one. All right.
You better get this answer right.
So, time to answer the question. Hey, yeah. The question for you is let me reset my thing. A halberd is worth 20 gold pieces, typically. True or false? 30 seconds.
What is that question?
True!
The lights flash. They go purple. Then they go green.
Bring! Yeah!
True. It is worth 20 gold pieces in the thingy majiggy majiggy. Guess
okay, everybody's saying false. These motherfuckers.
Guessing E.
False. Get wrecked, chat. How much does a halberd cost? Halberd's a fucking decent ass weapon.
Get wrecked.
Yeah.
Decent ass.
E. E decent for Elspeth. And that D-A-W. Is the only E.
That's the only E.
Yeah.
Really?
What? Is there an E?
100% sure.
One.
100% sure. Brad, third word.
100%.
What?
Sure. The lights localize.
Oh wow.
I feel like
John, you love something else. I got you, dude.
And they're just letters thrown in there.
Do you know what? That would be amazing, and I wish I'd done that.
didn't make any word. That'd be hilarious. It's just like "Escudi vraka da."
For any diehard fans, this is essentially your will versus Faelith's will trying to break from this spell. That's how I justify this bullshit. But no, it is real. It's a real thing. Pith. Spin the wheel of a fortune, eh?
My turn. Let's do this again.
18.
Ooh. No!
Lose
I've
a sanity
zero
point.
Zero sanity points now.
Zero sanity. Oh. Set it to 5 and roll me a D100.
Oh, no. Faelith, this could be so bad.
Faelith heads over to you. She cops a feel and gives you a big old smooch.
95.
On the mush. All right, so this is, I mean, you're just getting your own.
So for anyone who's just joining, anytime we go to zero sanity points,
you get an indefinite madness, which indefinite is essentially madness. It's kind of like a character flaw. It works in a way like, usually when you roll a character, you come up with different traits for the RP, and you usually have a flaw to give you some inspiration. These
I
are like
super
flaws.
Lucked out on mine though. Like I these super are, lucked yeah. out on mine.
These are sort of flaws that you
have
to
have
play
to carry into our main campaign. So that's
yeah.
just for anyone.
And you stick with them forever. So this one again, it isn't too bad. You're just getting all the flaws that you kind of already maybe sort of partially have. As she draws away from you, you begin to laugh. It's so hysterical. This is just a funny situation. You've probably gone a bit Harley Quinn here. I can't take anything seriously. The more serious the situation, the funnier
that's
I find
so
it.
That's so good. That's such so a great thing for
that's actually, that's actually so pretty that's great. So...
Copy that into your flaws.
That's so good.
For the record, you guys can get rid of this, but you need to find out. You need to find someone who can cast a powerful enough kind of curative restoration-y kind of spell. Chaplin is not powerful enough no matter how hard he tries. You can get rid of these. It's just not as simple. It's not a very simple way of doing it. It's gonna be. It's just you have to find a way later on.
I'm still trying not to puke from having a tooth in my mouth.
So yeah. So Pith, you go back up to 5 sanity points. It's not over yet. Oh yeah, you get to answer a question. So the lights dim a little bit on you, and you get your weapons section question.
Yes.
Let me reset my fucking timer. Sorry, went a bit northern then. It's embarrassing. Northern people. Mr. Faxum, Faxum Bomberry says to you, the trident has the following properties. Thrown, versatile, heavy. True or false?
True.
30 seconds. The lights all go red. Versatile. It doesn't have the heavy property. It has thrown. It has versatile.
I would have assumed.
But it doesn't have heavy. I don't have anything that you can
I'm
throw
thinking
has the
like
heavy
the
property.
Fucking trident from like goddamn Under the Sea bullshit.
I don't know why it's not heavy either.
Why the fuck is it not heavy?
If it's in water, it's not heavy.
You know that one with that fucking redheaded bitch? Oh yeah, you know what I'm talking about.
You know that redheaded bitch?
God damn it. Hey, language.
Hag is laughing from behind the bar. And then the lights.
Stop.
The lights.
Yeah.
Shine onto Mr. Clutch.
Right.
Giving it a spin of that wheel, please.
Boom.
Big money. Big fucking money. Six. Six is gain a sanity.
Yeah!
Nice.
So you get to gain a sanity. You feel good.
Feeling it.
You get some sanity back.
Perfect.
And then you get to answer a question. Nope. Next segment of questions. There were 4 segments and I forgot. what is it? Which one? This one. All right. Your question. Faxon von Baxenbury stands forward and looks at you. Then his tongue lolls out of his mouth. He says, "Oh no!" And then,
can you repeat
the
question?
And then he shakes his head, and Faelif does this behind him. And then he shakes his head and says, "Your question, Mr. Clutch, from the other world. Beautiful, luscious Clutch, with your wonderful eyes and your strange facial features." You're a human. Faelif thinks it's fucking sin a human. he says, "Your question, my love, my sweet, wonderful Clutch, is a supreme healing potion restores 10d4 plus 20 HP. True or false?" 30 seconds.
Absolutely true.
The lights all go out. Boom. There's a moment where you're just in complete darkness, and then they come back up.
Ring. Yeah.
You are correct. Faelif like kind of stumbles a little behind the bar and drops her glass, and then looks up like, and then Baxen from Baxenbury just starts doing this, and pointing around. The room starts to break more.
The room's breaking.
The room's fucking up. Yeah, you're starting to like just see like room like what every now and then kind of looks like this like a bar, like a tavern, and then kind of sometimes looks like a cave. Yeah, you get to guess a letter.
T. I will put in the word letter T.
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 Yeah, T.
Wow. Wait. Well, whoa. Are you in my head?
One T there.
T for Tiger Rider.
Yeah, T for Tiger Rider. He's a streamer, I think. On
doing
Twitch.
This, ding, the T appears and yes. He just carries on. That's it.
There's only one T.
Only one T.
T.
I bet Chapo, I know what the letters are.
Chapo Mon Chapo Lane. The lights fall to you. You get to spin the wheel as you reach out. To spin for the wheel. Roll me a dexterity saving throw.
Uh-oh.
Ha! Wait, where we go? Bam! Duken!
As you failed. As you go to grab for the wheel, the thing that you're going to grab to spin it turns into a snake and it just bites your wrist. And then it disappears and turns back into a thing. Your wrist, bleeding and swelling up very quickly, just suddenly returns to normal for a moment. And then you look down and you're fine. No damage, but there was a frightening moment where it looked like your wrist was going to explode and the thing was a snake. Do you want to try and spin the wheel again?
Yeah.
Yeah. Roll me a dexterity saving throw.
Please
don't be too low.
The thing coils up your wrist and turns into a snake and bites you further up the arm.
Can I use my wisdom? Because Here's the thing. This is what I'm doing.
Okay, Mr. D&D 3.
Something bit my arm, then popped up my arm like it was a poison.
Yeah.
Like, that's what normally would happen. But then my arm returned to normal. So, I want to roll a wisdom saving throw to see if this is actually happening and something's trying to trick me into
Don't even need to. You're definitely inside of an illusion. You've been in one of these illusions before.
So, I'm just going to fucking spin the wheel.
Yeah. Go on then, spin the wheel.
Get out of here! Selfie. D&D, there ain't no selfies in D&D. How?
Kiss the hag again.
Kiss the hag! As the snake is coiled around you and you spin the thing and the snake is whipped off your arm and spins around, the hag appears next to you and just kisses you lightly on each eyelid.
Ooh,
and you get to answer a question. The lights dim once again. Faxon Bomb Baxenbury, now just completely a ghoul, just a horrible undead, just a walking dead zombie.
Oh, I see the truth. All right.
Looks like a walking dead zombie of like an elf or something. Looks over to you and adjusts his now non-existent bow tie, and like kind of just does this.
And he's almost dead, dude.
Hey, this isn't too bad for Chaplin. He says, a healing word is a first level spell. True or false?
Ooh.
True.
Bing! All of the lights shine. Nice. The whole place shakes. From above your table, some of the ceiling falls apart and turns into rocks and lands near you, and then they disappear. With a splash, they turn into water as the illusion around you starts to shake a little bit. And then Baxen von Baxenbury, now just a ghoul with a voice, points at the letters and says, you may guess the letter now.
Oh, that'll be the letter L.
Ooh.
The letter L.
What?
In exactly the same voice as Chaplin, Baxen von Baxenberry says, is there a letter L on the board there? there's one there.
What?
Then there's one there?
What?
Yeah.
The last one's not fractured.
What is that fracture, you ding dong? There will be an E at the end of it.
I still thought he messed up.
Okay.
Fractured butthole. And then Faxon von Baxenbury looks at you. You want to try and guess?
No. I can't tell. I'm not good at word puzzles at all, so this is gonna be very hard for me.
Oh my god, I figured out the last word.
But you are the one for the question, so it evens out. The lights shine on poo poo cakes, you get to spin the wheel.
I think I figured out the thingy.
That's cool. You still gotta go through the thing.
You gotta get the question right. If you figure it out,
you gotta get.
I just gotta figure out if that the word is spelt the way that I think.
Like, we all should know what the second word is.
What?
If we don't, someone doesn't know the English language.
You have to guess the whole phrase, by the way.
Yeah, I've definitely got the last one, for sure.
Toe is 100 the better
gold. 10.
Feral toe 100. Furrow.
I was going to say gold. Tie.
Did you really just roll 100 gold again? Are you serious? He's going to be rich after this. Every roll.
You get 100 gold. that appears in the real world in
222 gold.
Honestly, 220 gold in this campaign is shit.
It's good for you guys. Never get gold. Dope for you.
We need to go kill a dragon and raid its horde.
I am nice kill for most stuff, but I'm a dickhead for gold. I'm so
mad because I figured out the last word, but I can't figure out the first word.
You have to guess the whole thing, otherwise
I know.
Fuck up. All right. So the you get a question.
Yeah.
Fax and Bomb Baxum Berry the Ghoul looks at you and says, Hellish Rebuke can be cast as a ritual or a reaction. True or false?
Ooh. A ritual or a what?
A reaction.
What was the spell called one more time?
You can tell Hellish who the Rebuke. True D&D nerd is in this group. Oh, it's...
True.
Bang! False, it's just a reaction.
God damn it.
Just a reaction, yeah.
McLoken
like has a version of Hellish Rebuke. He's got like he's got Thunderous Rebuke.
Wrath of the Storms.
Oh my god.
Can I still guess?
You can still guess the whole phrase, but you don't get a letter.
Okay.
Oh, guess it and tell us what the last word is.
I know what the last word is. I don't know. I'm not gonna do it because I know what the last word is.
Come on, what's the last word, buddy?
I'm just give me 1 second to figure out the first word, which is gonna be. The problem with it is my brain wants to keep thinking that there's like an R at the beginning of the first one, but it's not. You know, no, I'm not gonna guess. But also, do I get kissed by the hag after that?
No, you don't. Okay, you don't good. Fail for lose. You don't
good.
Lose one on the
good,
question.
Good.
So you're not guessing.
There's
only one question left. But you all get to guess at the end once.
Okay, good.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, no.
We don't get to get us any more letters?
No, because I haven't got any more questions.
Oh, wait. I got it. Battle the Dracolich.
Battle.
That's not how you spell battle, brother.
Oh, B-A-T. Oh, yeah,
shout,
yeah, never mind.
Battle the Dracolich. And Baxen von Baxenberry, like, looks up and all the lights go red. You lose the sanity because
I lose the sanity for guessing?
Yeah. If you guess incorrectly, you lose the sanity. You get a kiss. Mwah, you lose the sanity. What are you on?
What are you at?
Zero.
Again?
Zero.
Oh, zero.
No, that's set my your, first time.
This is your flaw, then.
Oh, he's rolling. D100,
set your sanity. Set your sanity to 5 because it goes back up to the top.
Oh, I'm excited to see what Poop is going to get.
What if he has to like be really nice?
What if he gets something like horrible, like life-saving? What if he has to be nice?
This is really interesting, Tiger, because we and Tiger at the moment are in a very short campaign on Wax Stevens' channel called Deviants, and my character basically has this against Tiger's character.
Fuck.
So this is really weird. So the floor you get, you are now... I am convinced that powerful enemies are hunting me and their agents are everywhere I go. I'm sure they're watching me all the time.
Oh no.
He's paranoid as fuck.
He's like fucking paranoid
so
as shit.
Paranoid. No.
Also, Tiger, how hysterical is that? Because I can't help it. Like my little creature, I have this like 6-year-old boy that is convinced that Tiger is an agent who's trying to hunt me in this fucking campaign we're doing. It's so weird.
It's bullshit.
Dude, that's
amazing.
God, now Poopoo's gonna be all on the edge.
Poopoo's gonna be even
like
more.
He wasn't fucking before.
And it's even more unbearable.
Gonna be even
as soon
more,
as she
like...
kisses me, she lets me go and I go, where are the elves? Where are the elves?
The elves.
Where are the elves?
We killed
one of their leaders. They're going to kill us. Where are they else?
She dances away from you, giggling, and all the lights close in on Pith. And Baxen Flom Baxen Barry says, this is the last question, or else you'll be trapped here forever.
Yay!
And Flaxen Bon Craxen Grary says to Pith, as all the lights dim down.
That's not how you spell battle.
True resurrection can bring a creature back to life that has been dead for no longer than 500 years. True or false?
What?
Can you repeat the question, please?
True resurrection can bring a creature back to life that has been dead for no longer than 500 years. True or false?
Pit didn't spin.
She didn't spin.
Yeah,
answer anyway.
That's...
She's still going to do it either way.
Yeah, okay. Everyone's
Three.
True.
Fax and Bombamber, he says, spin the wheel.
What? Why do I have to do this? Why do I just want to go with it? Oh, I did take her.
Oop. 16.
What'd she get?
Punch Chaplin!
I hope you get this question wrong.
You feel compelled to punch Chaplin in his beautiful face. Roll me a d20 plus 3 plus your strength.
Oh my god.
All right, wait. D20 plus 3 plus your strength?
Yeah.
My strength
like 4
is...
or 5. What the fuck you have?
I think it's probably
my strength is 5.
That was beautiful.
Plus 8.
Thank you. Really, so that's beautiful. Plus 8. So sorry about your beautiful face.
Chaplin, what is your AC? 19. Roll me damage.
Yeah.
Wait, what do you mean damage? She rolled a 15.
Wait. How do I roll damage on a punch?
It's 1 plus your strength, so it's just 6.
So 1d8.
I think you just get 6. I think it's just 6.
Just 6?
Chaplin like puffs up his chest. Goes to move, stands there for a moment, and then suddenly is rooted to the spot. His chest looks normal. He's wearing almost nothing at all but a loincloth, and then he gets clocked in the face. Bam!
Boom!
6 damage. Take 6 HP off.
Sorry, Chaplin. Six
bludgeoning damage?
I felt
six
very compelled damage. To do that.
And then he pops back into his normal self with his weird metal chest. Then all the lights go... red. False. 200
years. I have not
gotten
a question right. I haven't gotten a single 200 question
years.
Right.
All right, you get 200? To guess.
Guess. Oh, fuck.
All right, wait, I gotta lose a sanity point. Hold on. God damn it.
Oh, that's true. You have what to lose a sanity point.
I'm at 4.
How would this be?
You're at... Oh, well.
H. H.
You know, you have to guess with a word. You failed. You don't get a letter.
Oh, wait. Oh, I have to guess with a word?
You don't have to guess it. You can if you want, is what I'm saying.
I have to guess a word.
You want to guess the whole phrase.
Oh,
you want to guess the
whole
thing. You don't have to do it.
Oh, wait.
Oh.
Calling the...
Oh, no.
Dracolich.
But there would be an L.
Shut
up. I love you so much.
Backs and fan backs and bro points. Calling the Dracolich! You lose another sanity point.
Oh, my
and,
God.
And then... The music suddenly stops. And Thalith steps forward from behind the bar and says,
"Well then, it seems you get one last guess each at the entire phrase, or you're mine forever. Clutch, my love."
Okay, yeah, no problem. Wash. Nope. Wesley.
No, all the letters don't make sense, do they?
Wesley the Dracolich.
Wesley the Dracolich.
Wesley on.
Wesleyan the Dracolich!
You guys are stuck on Dracolich and it's fucking me up. Like,
Clutch loses sanity point.
What? Oh, I'm at 1.
The Faelith looks over to Chaplin.
Chaplin.
I think it's definitely Dracolich.
This is what I'm gonna tell you, Faileth. I cannot guess this word puzzle because my brain can't wrap around it. But if you want to work out a deal, I don't have to guess.
You don't have to guess.
But no, if you want to work out a deal, I can work out a deal with you.
Sure.
And it'll be a deal, but it has to be after everyone guesses, and all of us will be safe if you agree to my terms.
I figured it out.
No, she says, and
your loss. Pass.
She waves you off. Who's next? Poo Poo Cake. She looks to you.
I look at her and I scream because. Nobody guessed I, right?
No.
Okay. Failing the Dracolich.
Oh, shit.
Failing the Dracolich.
Yeah, you got it.
Come on.
Oh!
I did it. I was like, F-A-I-L-I-N-G.
You lose a sanity point, and then she turns to Pip.
Oh, no.
One last chance, Pip.
You gotta admit it sounded good.
I thought it was it. I put my hands up.
I assumed that it would be it. Pith, we might be here for a long time.
You got this. Pith, what's that face?
Hey, if you don't get this right, we're stuck here forever.
Pith, do you have to go to the bathroom?
No.
She's taking a shit.
How long can I take with this?
You get 30 seconds from now.
Oh!
But you have to stay looking at the camera.
Okay.
Her reaction was present.
Well, I'm looking. Can I at least look at the phrase?
Yeah, you can do that a little bit. Where's chat? Where's chat?
What's chat?
Oh my gosh.
Failing?
This is
three, two,
one.
Failing?
Yes. Nothing?
Nothing. I've got nothing. I've literally got nothing.
There's a terrible laughter from Faileth.
Too easy.
And she heads over to you, Clutch, and she puts a hand on the side of your face and
Failing?
Says,
"You're the one that saved the world, huh? The gods are weaker than I thought."
And then she turns
I grab her.
Yeah? Your arms turn to petroleum jelly.
I don't care. I don't care if I turn petroleum jelly. I'm like, blah.
Your body turns to petroleum jelly. Your head
turns.
You turn into an ooze. You are an ooze now.
I poke him with my quarterstaff. I pork and stir. I pork.
Can we all just agree that Brad saying yeah was the most badass thing he's ever said on stream? Yeah, like you grab the hag. Okay.
The hag like takes a few steps away from you and then she spins around once again and she says,
"I'll give you a clue in exchange for a soul."
And then she pulls out she pulls out a bag.
Not doing this again.
Shakes it around.
Nope.
She looks at each of you. Pith, shaking a soul bag at you.
Wait, why do you need a soul?
She opens it up and you see all these weird souls fly out and spin around the room. They're weird little faces. They're like little kind of ghosts that spin around the room, screaming and freaking out. And then she closes the bag and they
raise
all
my
drawn
hand.
Back into it again. And she says,
"I like them."
I raise my hand. I have a.
How about, can I take another guess?
For a soul.
How about a free guess, and I give you 30 of the gold back that I won?
How about a soul?
How about you suck me? I'm not going to give you my soul.
She clicks her fingers, and he turns into a giant inflatable penis and just hits the ground. You can no longer speak. He's an ooze. You're a giant inflatable penis. And she looks then to Clutch and Pith and says,
"Looks like it's just you two." soul.
What if we don't want to give you our soul?
Then the game is over. And you're mine.
And if we do give you our soul, you keep it forever, or can we get it back later? Is it just like
a... She gives us a clue if one of us gives her our soul.
No, I think I know the answer, so I don't really need a clue. But... is that the only thing we can do? Are we stuck out of options?
She's just shaking the soul bag.
Soul for a guess, soul for a clue.
Can I roll a goddamn will save or something to get out of fucking... ooze form?
No. That's it.
I slowly start rolling towards the ooze.
I move in on her, and I say, do you remember last night? It was so nice. There was something so beautiful about the way you moved.
And she trails a finger down your face, and immediately you're broken from the enchantment, and you see her for the true horrible creature, and you remember everything from last night. You remember all the things you did to her. You remember eating out her asshole.
Jesus fuck.
Maggot filled.
You did everything. You lose a sanity point.
I lose a what?
You lose a sanity point.
I'm at zero.
Really?
No, I'm at one. I'm at one. I'm at one. I'm at one.
He loses two.
Piff? Yeah, what do we do?
Well, here's the thing. If we don't get it, then we're all stuck here. If we do get it, then one of us will absolutely be with her after we die.
Rock, paper, scissors for our soul?
I'm casting dispel magic on myself.
Okay.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Do you play shoot or no shoot?
I'm dispelling the ooze spell on me.
All right, you dispel the ooze spell, but it doesn't work. You just now have a set of googly eyes on top of the ooze.
I am googling eyeing the hag super hardcore. And I'm
really
like,
hard. It's really hard to do. They're kind of going all over the place.
The best human form I can, and I'm standing in front of her and googly eyeing all over the place.
You're wobbling around on the floor. You're wobbling around on the floor, and the eyes are going everywhere.
No, I'm fucking googly eyeing the fuck out of her right now.
Yeah, that's cool. Rock, paper, scissors.
For our soul. Hey, no shoot. I don't play that shit. 3, 2, 1, you throw it.
Okay.
3, 2, 1. Alright, on time now.
Again. Right.
3, 2, 1.
You waited! You waited!
Faelith claps. And opens the bag.
Your soul, Pip.
I didn't know it.
Pledge your
soul. You took a second to see what I threw out. That's captured on this stream right now. Everyone saw that.
Yeah.
You absolute... Here.
Faelith, sorry.
I don't know how to give you my soul. I've never done this sort of transaction before.
Say yes.
No.
There's a delay.
I'm removing curse on myself. God damn it.
You get like a little sticker of like a little like anime cummies tongue that appears like on your Google googly oozy body.
Yes, take it.
Can I cast shatter on her? Oh my god.
You say yes, and she claps twice. Clutch turns into an arrow, bung, and hits the ground spinning. And then you actually have this very similar situation, and she says,
"How ironic."
And you feel like a cold feeling from inside your body. This pure white light of your soul pulled forth from your body, and then she catches it in this bag. Then the room dims a little bit, and she says,
"Would you like to guess, or would you like a clue?"
I would like a clue, please.
The irony. The last time you lost your soul was to this one.
And she points at the letters.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, my God. Oh. It's so funny that it's her. It's so funny that it's her.
Oh.
Would you like to guess?
What
is fucking name?
Fuck!
I start flopping around as my balls and my penis start going back and forth on the ooze that clutches or the chaplain's got on the ground.
I start bubbling.
There's an arrow stuck in the ooze.
I'm hard.
Making a whistling noise.
Is it? Malak the Dracolich?
The Baxton von Baxtonberry says, Malak the Dracolich! And then the letters start, Malak the...
Is it really Malak?
Dracolich! Malak, it doesn't say it. It does say it. They all fill in. Bing, 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 and Malak, the Dracolich, is spelled out instantly.
Yeah.
There's a moment where for Miriam and for Miriam alone.
That V is though.
The room shimmers and shakes, and Miriam alone, you are snapped out of this thing. Suddenly you find yourself unentranced. All of the fucking shit around you disappears, and it's just you and the hag. And I need you to roll initiative because she's coming at you.
Oh what?
She runs at you like crazy.
Oh my, it's battle time?
Yeah. Piff's gonna 1v1.
Wait, I'm gonna roll again to see if I get higher initiative.
Yeah, you have all your shit on you. Like nothing, you're just sat in your own stuff. It's right next to you.
Okay.
What do you have here? Bam. You go first. The hag suddenly sees you and she runs at you straight away. But you've sitting there, you can whip up Terrathorn and run at her or whatever you want. The other three are just asleep, like zoned out on the ground.
Guys, all right.
They're out of it.
She runs at her with Terrathorn.
Hitting her twice.
Yep.
One hit. 9 damages. Let's see here. You come running at her and she goes to, like, swipe at you with these horrible claws that she's got, but you just about get under her guard. You miss your first swipe, but then bring the thing across the front of her, inside of her kind of open arms, and you cut across her stomach. There's a terrible stench. It's even more powerful in the real world than it was in the illusion, as you catch the horrid smell of her, and then her blood pours out of her, far too dark to be natural. It's almost like an ichor. Anything else on your turn?
This is so sick. Just 1v1ing the hag.
Yeah, I'm gonna use an extra fucking a lunging attack.
Yeah.
Yep, I'm gonna roll a superiority die.
Yeah.
And just make a lunging attack at her. Boink.
Blammo. Yeah, an extra 2 damage.
Jesus.
To the hag. You cut deeper and she
I'm drinking.
She
why am I laughing? Okay.
I had forgotten.
Here we go.
She brings her hand back and brings it down towards you, attempting to swipe and cut at you. That is a 19. What is your AC?
My AC is 22.
22?
22 or 23. Oh, yeah.
Are you in the fucking bullshit? Are you in the bullshit armor?
It's 23,
armor?
Yes.
Yeah, she just
armor.
She hits the bullshit armor and just you feel it like scrape across the front of it. It doesn't leave even a single mark on the armor. She twists and looks at you. She's shocked. She looks at her hand and she's confused as she looks at the armor. Your turn.
Funny joke, that. She's just gonna keep swiping her with Zerathorn. We're just gonna keep going at her.
Cool.
Cause that's all piss knows. Hi-ya!
Two hits.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
So, this is 19 damage there, which means. Clutch, you wake up. Roll initiative.
Clutch!
I'm here.
Clutch! What's are you happened? Okay?
Oh, she's still hideous. Yeah.
You wake up and you see the hag kind of bleeding a little from the front and just standing in front of her is Pith with Terrathorn. And you roll me an initiative.
Oh, shit.
And yeah, so it's now just in that order. so it's her go. She's going to swipe at you again. That's definitely a miss. Again, she scratches across the front of you and clutch.
Yeah. All right, so I look at her and I say,
fuck you, hag. Not literally anymore.
And I pull back my bow, casting Hunter's Mark on her, and I fire that longbow straight into her face. No. The asp. Straight into her face. Two times. Oh my god, did they both miss?
Both miss. She ducks and weaves out of the way.
No, my love.
Pith.
Yes, hello. I thought I just went.
Yeah, well, there's not as many turns because there's only two of you.
Oh. Well, let's do this again.
Two misses. And then.
Dear Lordy.
Chaplain, you wake up.
Yeah.
Oh.
You're not loose.
He's
back, boys.
The Romian initiative. The hag. Takes actually she's gonna yeah she's
how did I miss both my arrow shots
17 all right so the hag does a little swipe a rooney at Pith she swipes down the front of you. There's a moment where it almost catches your actual face, but you just dodge out of the way and she
whatever.
Fast. Clutch.
Yep.
Your turn.
All right, back with the asp, pulling it back.
Back asp it again.
Back asp it again.
I can't even say that, to be honest. Here we go, two shots. Boom, hit. Let's go.
Two hits, give me that damage.
No problem. Boom and boom. Plus this. Did she have damage on her?
Yep. Give me all of it.
Love it. It's been a while. 2d6. Hunter's Mark works both, right?
You get a d6 on
a
both and a d6 and a d8.
On both. All right, cool. So, boom.
What? No, I can't remember. I don't care. Do what you want.
That seems like too much. No, it doesn't. It seems perfect. 5, 6, 7, or 8, 9, 10, 13, plus 25, 42. 42 damage.
42 damage. There's a lot of damage. You fire two arrows. Where are you here? One jabs her in the shoulder. The next one goes straight into the side of her neck. It comes out the other side and begins to bleed. She's like spun around one way, but she doesn't die.
Oh, it's 32. It's 32. I'm so sorry.
Doesn't matter. She's
okay.
Still not dead.
Okay, 32.
I mean, it
I'm
does
on
matter,
mass,
but
man.
It does matter, but it's not that.
Right,
not
right.
That.
Cool, cool, cool.
She, you still catch her in the neck. It would be a kill shot on anyone else, but it is not a kill shot.
Next week, we're hosting Drunk Math, where you just have to do math questions while taking shots when you get them wrong.
God.
That's pretty much what this is to me, anyway.
That.
Oh,
I always have to do fucking math.
So hard.
Chaplain, your turn.
All right, this is what I'm going to do. This is going to sound completely insane. I'm running up to her, 5, 10, 15, right there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab her by the neck and I'm pushing her away from everyone and slamming her to the ground 10, 20, right there on the ground. And I'm holding off everyone else from attacking her.
Wait, what? I have no idea. What are you pushing her or are you
okay,
grabbing
this
her?
Is what I'm going to do.
You can either push or you can grab.
I imagine I'm pushing her because I'm grabbing her.
You can shove her, but you can't.
Can I grab her by the neck and like fucking push her?
No. Basically, there are two moves. There's one called shove, where you push a creature, or there's grapple, where you try and grapple her, and then
it'd
you
be
can
a
drag
jelly
her.
Jelly bro again, dude.
And you can drag her.
I have an idea.
You can grapple and then drag or carry her next turn.
Googly
if you
goo,
successfully
bro.
Do it.
Okay, this is what I'm gonna do. This is what I'm gonna do. I'm going to attempt to start grappling her around the neck. But as I do that, I'm going to cast my very faithful Guardian of Faith.
Ooh, nice.
Okay.
And so I'm placing that right next to her. Yeah. And so what I'm gonna do is as I'm like moving in next to her, I'm like, no one make an attack. I'm giving her a choice. Please let me do this.
You're giving the crazy hag bitch a choice.
Yeah, you just wait. And then like, that's what I'm doing. I'm like going towards her neck and like, I'm looking at her and I'm like, this is what, she's gonna die or she has a choice. And then I'm basically looking at her and it's like, you're gonna have a choice. You can either choose to attack us or you can hear out what we're gonna say. At least what I'm gonna say and see what they are gonna do.
Okay, she looks at you wild-eyed and feral.
I look at her fucking crazy as fuck
as
well.
And she looks back at you crazy as fuck. And then this thing appears next to her.
I fucking don't give a shit. I'm drunk.
So then, Piff, you can do. It's your turn. Piff, it's your turn. Pooper Cakes, you also wake up. Give me an initiative roll.
When I wake up, the first thing that happens though is I run 2 or 5 blocks and I just start screaming, yes, 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 yes.
Yep.
Yeah,
that's it.
He's gone.
He's rolling an issue.
Do I still have fucking javelins?
Always.
Probably.
You always have. You have unlimited javelins in this campaign. Like, we have not talked about how many javelins you pulled out of who knows where.
Always had.
She's like,
javelins.
I think I have
you
a javelin.
You're the Hawkeye of javelins.
I've only
honestly,
got 2
you're
javelins
just like,
left.
Hey, I'm going to fight a fucking battalion of aliens with a fucking quiver of arrows,
like,
but it's
I've
javelin.
I've like 90 javelins.
I'm dead.
All right, I'm not going to use a javelin, though. That would be cheating. I'm going to use Terrathorn.
No, it's not
again.
Cheating.
So you just play better with Terrathorn again. Here you go! Boop!
Alright. Give me the damage. You go directly against Chaplin's orders. And in doing so...
Oh, what? I didn't hear
yeah,
a word
I totally,
Chaplin
I totally,
said.
I totally did not get told her... I totally said don't attack her.
Oh, whoops. Sorry.
You attack her and you stab... Faileth in the stomach.
Yeah.
Anything else on your turn?
And then I twist it.
No!
Roll me a d8.
Cool.
I guess that's a battle move. An extra 7 damage.
Yeah. Sorry about your lower intestine, love.
Love.
She looks rough as shit. She looks over to Chaplin. And then as he's reaching out...
I'm like, everyone, stop! I'm yelling at everyone.
She does this. And she disappears.
Peace out?
No!
She peaced!
I'm not gonna fuck a hag a third time. Brad, please. This is a meme.
You probably would have killed her if Chaplin had done damage. Unfortunately... She shifts to another plane of existence.
Oh no.
And disappears on very small amounts of health. Oh. And you are all left in the dark marsh in a cave. in this cave, there is, it's just dark. It's just dark in the cave. Outside, you hear the reeds and strange noises of the dark marsh. And across, way across the map, far away, Pozu is sitting on the airship, and he's standing, like, looking out over the tree lines at Thorellian, and he kicks the edge of the ship and says, "Where's the signal? I'm getting bored." And that's where we end today's session.
Oh, Pozu!
We are literally days away from Pozu.
You left him, and you told him to wait until you gave him the signal. He's fucking miles away. You guys are somewhere over here.
Wait, poor Pozu.
Poor guy. We're
in dark marsh right now.
You are somewhere in dark marsh, and we'll pick up next week as you guys deal with that. As you have, yeah, whatever. I don't know.
I am so happy I didn't get any new skills.
I had such a great idea that I was like, this is gonna be great. This is gonna be a great idea. And it didn't happen because everyone, oh my God.
What was your idea? Because she can plane shift.
Yeah, what was your idea?
My idea was that, like, I was going to persuade her to be a jailer for us, to jail everyone that we brought to her, to be, and she could do whatever she wanted to the people we jailed because they were evil, and she could do whatever she wanted as long as she left our party alone, and we worked out an agreement.
Wait, Mick Loken, you understand? Today was like the drunk episode, right?
Yeah. Yeah, and I came up with this drunk.
You're trying to make power moves, dude. Big old power moves.
Brad, would that have worked?
Hell no. No, probably not.
Brad,
really?
No,
because she was on the verge of death. I was going to kill her.
Well,
she plane warped.
And then she went to another plane.
And now I have to deal with her. Wait, Brad, how is my penis, though? Seriously.
Roll me a constitution saving throw.
Oh!
Oh, fuck off, yeah?
Where it goes.
Two.
Where is it?
15. Hey!
How is it?
No, hide your dick.
You had to beat a 16.
Fuck off! Brad! You have that written down? Show me it. Show me it right now.
I don't know if I can, but I can show you my fucking mouse. It says 16. Ooh, 16. Sus, bro.
What the fuck is that?
You feel a strange yet familiar itching in your sort of groin area.
Can I lay hands on his dick?
No, it didn't work before. Has he got any McLotion?
Why didn't you lay it? Didn't work
no,
before.
I didn't
have that ability before.
I lost the McLotion.
Oh, no.
So now I have to go hunting in markets for
McLotion. Why you gotta keep an emergency stash of McLotion?
The only thing that heals this is McLotion.
It's McLotion? Do I know how to make McLotion?
No. Where the fuck did you even get
it? I can't even remember where you got it.
I don't know, I think I'm losing my dick this season.
He got it from Mr. Suna before. But Mr. Suna is dead.
Suna's dead.
Suna's dead.
I have a medicine check. Also, I have
It doesn't matter, McLotion. The only thing. The only thing in the world that cures it is McLotion.
How long do I have? Please tell me longer than 60 days.
How long do I have, Doc?
I want to make a baby with this lady.
Last time it progressed pretty quickly. Remember, it was like 3 days before it started showing symptoms.
No matter what, and you're going to impregnate the Seraph with a Hydra dick? That's rude.
So rude.
You're right. There's
bad form.
She does lesser restoration on her vagina. I mean, fucking, there we go.
Nothing works except for McLotion. We'll figure this out next episode. Hey, thank you all so much for coming out to our drunk D&D session. A little shorter than normal, but when you get drunk, it gets hard to start concentrating. That's why I was so blown away by McLotion being so, like, involved. I was like, how is he thinking of this right now? All I want to do is go, click roll. I hit you. Yeah.
It's
called years of a fucking experience. That's what it is.
I'm so angry.
Always the most simple ever session.
Oh man.
I planned out in my head. I was like, I'm gonna have the hag be our jailer. So like, as the guardians, we bring people who were bad to the hag, and she can do whatever the fuck she wants with them. We don't question
it. But she's a dick.
What kind?
Yeah, I don't know. She's a dick, but they're bad people, so they deserve it. So fucking bad. Like, we won't question.
But you're still not accepting the she's a dick part. You're just jumping part. You're leapfrogging the fact that will never happen, and still hoping it will.
Yes,
Matt.
Yes.
Madness.
I'm drinking. Leave me alone.
I love it.
You got very, very, very slim chances of that kind of thing happening.
Tiger.
I have a high persuasion.
You
We're starting with you, baby boy.
I have a high DC.